Hey everyone, this is Roscoe, and welcome to part 21 of the LP of LEGO Star Wars, The Complete Saga. Chapter 4, Dagobah! Han Solo and Princess Leia have finally evaded the Imperial fleet in the Millennium Falcon, and are on their way to Cloud City, secretly followed by the bounty hunter Boba Fett. Meanwhile, following instructions relayed in by the spectral form of Obi-Wan Kenobi, Luke Skywalker has piloted his X-Wing to the forgotten planet of Dagobah. Accompanied by his trusty droid R2-D2, Luke heads towards a murky swamp world in search for his destiny. Yeah, this is one of the longest levels in the game. And blush. Yay. No, I'm impressed he's still A-okay after that. I mean, seriously, a giant fall, a pretty damn good fall like that would have knocked out anyone. R2! Where are you? Ugh. Oh, Jesus Lord! Oh! I'm impressed he stole the One Piece! No, seriously. Now, the enemies here are bats. No, I'm not kidding. Bats. Bats are your biggest enemies in this level. Yes, after you've accepted the fact that bats are your enemies, you can continue on with this part. It's the dumbest sounding thing ever. I know you needed enemies, okay? But seriously, you didn't need an enemy in every freaking level. Why do I care? Sorry, not what I wanted to do. I barely made that. Actually, you're just supposed to go across from left to right, but I did that stupidly. Yeah, if you fall in there, it's instant death. I really don't like the cameras in this game, though. It's not what I expected. Come on, where do I have to go again? There we go. I'm not gonna make that. That's right, you have to use both R2 and Luke in order to pass through all the platforms. Now at least the AI is smart enough to, you know, jump to the next platform. Okay, I'm going to, oh no, I made it. Woo! Yes, control Luke and approach this little hut here. And Yoda, one of the most memorable, lovable characters in the series. You're a Jedi Master? And you deserve that, Luke. Not that, but, you know. The Force is capable of incredible feats. So, until you... So, the annoying thing about this level is that in order to use Force powers, you need Yoda. And in order to continue on with mostly the mission, you have to do exactly what I'm doing. And every time you die, Yoda leaps off and you have to go get him again. Yeah, until you have Yoda, Luke cannot use any force powers. So you're gonna be doing this a lot. Whoa. Now I know that's a bridge piece, but the annoying thing about it is that until you literally destroyed every flower, well, sorry R2, you won't be able to use the bridge at all. So I completely forgot to do one part of the bridge. And I know this. Because there's no way Luke can cross that. The angles of some of the computer, some of the platforms is weird too. There we go. I knew I forgot something. I meant to get Yoda on my back, not switch to R2. There you go, now we can cross, no problem. Now, these little manhole things. If you open all three within this sector, you'll unlock a collectible. I am so lucky that I decided not to go back down. So I don't know if you can double jump with Yoda on your back like that. Yes, you can. Okay. So like you see all three and your secret would appear here. Yay. Moving on. Dagobah has, I think, 5 or 6 areas. And it's right here I noticed that it's an R2 switch, so I just screwed this up. So we'll cut to when I succeed. Alright. So lower the first platform. Lower the second one. It didn't take long, I just didn't want you guys to see a bunch of failures. Anyone else find out that this little music here is a bit un-Star Wars-y? I don't know if that's even a possible phrase or wording, but you know, it doesn't sound like it belongs in the Star Wars movies as much. There we go. Get Yoda on my back. And let's keep moving. So now, in this area, Luke has his own force powers. I don't know why I should care. Okay, no, go down. Now this is a little tricky. You need to hover all the way here, but as you can see, you could barely make it, so you gotta be very careful not to bump into anything on your way here. This raises a platform for the two Jedis to use. Although technically going up one could probably make you reach it. Yeah, rather than using the Force, we're destroying things with our lightsaber. You must. Do not be afraid, chicken shit. And Yoda fell. Great Jedi Master, is he? How pathetic. I swear to God, sometimes I could barely make these platforms. That was stupid of me. Now, if you have a grappling character in free play, you get, I think, a secret up there. Like I said, I'm not going 100% because I don't care for it. And an R2. Now I'm doing this stupid, because this is the path R2 has to take, not Luke or Yoda. Oh, for frick's sakes. I hate it when that happens. The path we're supposed to take is going, oh, come on. Up here. And any of the higher platforms. R2 takes the lower path. And for those who can kind of remember this section from the movie, although this is not exactly how it happened, Darth Vader! Yes, it is the cave. I think everyone can remember these kind of puzzles. Now Yoda is gonna go faster up because of your power up. But don't worry, just use the same old tactics you've been using for the all lightsaber duels, and this part is a breeze. Due to this little glitch, you're invincible of the fact that when you jump, you're invincible. You don't need to worry about anything, really. There. See? That invulnerability frame moment allows you to cheat the game, really. Made the game somewhat easier. And you're just standing there, you idiot. Wow, that was pathetic. So, look where we are. This is the same area not far from Yoda's hut. Yes, we are literally back in this area 2 of the game. So this time we have Luke and Force powers. Wrong way. Okay, it's dead. Just let me go. I just find it weird that bats are our greatest enemies in this level. Now, as you can see, we don't have a control panel to open this door. We gotta find it. Which is actually pretty easy. And again, same thing as before. You go on one, Yoda goes on the other. And dumb glitching. Once you're high enough, you can just actually jump off. Making it to the top, though, grants you a surefire. The fact that you can easily make it. I don't mind this level, but it is annoyingly long for nothing. Mostly due to Area 2, and you're wondering what to do or even how to do it sometimes. And what do I think about this part in the movie? It's very good. This is well done moment in gaming. And movie making, I mean. You know, it's the old cliche of George Lucas said it best. You're nice to the weird creature with the magic. The hero's weird is nice to the weird creature with the magic, but everyone else hates him and he gains the power. You know. He said that well, and I agree with him. And this is part of the movie I like too, to show that the Force is so powerful that it can lift something as large as an X-Wing with no problem. Poor R2. Yeah, we don't even get a nice little cutscene, we're just told that. Yep, time to move on. They're doing this joke that the Rebels have little to no money and everything. So the X-Wings are falling apart and everything. You guys are supposed to try to stop them, not tell them to leave. And this part's starting to come to an end, so join me next time as we head to Bespin to rescue our friends. Don't forget to comment, rate, subscribe. Thank you, have a good day or night.